All right, so here's a visual of an expectation of what I'm looking for on the homework assignment. So the first thing I'm presented is a menu items with some 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 being add, 2 being multiply, 3 being divide, and then 4 exiting the program. And so I hope already in your mind you're visualizing that one of these is going to be a function that's going to add two numbers together, another function which will multiply the numbers together, a third function which is going to divide the numbers, and then if the person chooses 4, then they'll exit the program. So let's just go ahead and run this so we have an idea how it's supposed to work. So I'm going to click on 1, enter two numbers. I'm going to enter a 2 and a 7. That function, presumably called add, ran. It took the two numbers that it received and it added them together and then output the number. Notice that I'm in a loop. So I'm going to be prompted again if I would like to play again. And so I'm going to choose 2 to multiply. Again, I'm being prompted with two numbers. I'm going to do a 2 and a 7 again. This is going to run a second function, presumably called multiply or whatever you want to call it. That function is taking those two numbers in and multiplying them together and outputting 14. I'm going to choose 3 this time, and I'm going to divide two numbers. But there is a problem with division, and that is that I can't divide by 0, and so I need to make sure that I catch that. So if the user types in a 3 and a 0, I have something in place saying, oops, you can't divide a number by 0 because I don't want my program to crash because it cannot divide 3 divided by 0. If you don't believe me, go ahead and try and divide 3 by 0 in your program, and I'm guessing you're going to get a runtime error, which means your program will crash in the middle of it. I suggest you try it if you're a curious programmer. Be good lesson. Anyway, so I caught the fact that they input the wrong number and the loop went through again. So this time I'm going to choose 3 one more time and then I'll do something that would make sense. 6 and 2. And it did, in fact, say 6 divided by 2 is 3. I'm going to do something with a fraction and see if that works. Let's do 9 to line and 4 and let's see if we end up getting, we do. So I did take into account the fact that we might have a fraction. So just be aware of that. Not a fraction, but a decimal. Any rate, I'm going to now choose 4 to exit the program, and it does in fact exit the program. So this is what I'm looking for. I'm looking for 3 separate functions. Function 1, add. Function 2, multiply. Function 3, divide. I'm looking for a while loop so that the user can enter in as many times as they choose to, some kind of an exit. How you choose to do that is up to you. I just opted to do a 4 here. Depends how you want to set yours up. And then catch the division by 0. So make sure they don't divide something by 0. So make sure your program catches that too. Otherwise, your program will crash and it'll be very sad. I'll be very sad, and so will you and your grade. So, anyway, that's what I'm looking for. That's the assignment for the week.